Alright, what's going on, man? How you feeling? We in the building.
Brooklyn Fights in the building.
Nah, me God gifted Titus Lucius in the building. Well, first off, thank you, you know, for the invite, you know, for this fantastic documentary. Cradle of Champions, you can show the sign right there. You know what I mean? You did your thing, man.
I don't know if it's dropping tonight. If it dropped tonight, y'all better check it out tomorrow on Showtime, 8 p.m.
Yeah.
Check it out, man. We out here working hard.
Mm-hmm.
You know, getting to it.
Now, it was a packed crowd tonight. Fantastic documentary. Cinematography was fantastic.
Amazing.
The storyline, the following of both your career and James Wilkins throughout the, you know, the Golden Gloves tournament. What were your thoughts on everything that took place?
My thoughts about the actual documentary, that it was put together very well. You know, very professional. When it was first presented to me to be a part of it, I didn't really want to be a part of it because I didn't know. Like, I was ready. I was over the amateurs. I was ready to turn pro. And then they say, "Listen, we're gonna make this worth your while." And his specific words was, "Our goal is to get this on Showtime." And that always stuck with me. And the way he presented it to me, I said, "You know what? Let's do this." You know what I mean? And I just went for it, how big the Golden Gloves is, how big Showtime is, and how big I know I'm gonna be in this boxing world. I said, let's do this. It's a trifecta, and it's big, man. And I hope you guys enjoy it, check it out. I hope it inspires somebody, hope it motivates somebody. No matter what, go after what you love and keep pushing forward.
Now, being that they were following, you know, your whole, basically your training, your rising through the ranks and fighting, going for the next Golden Gloves that year, Did it change your mind on you need to do things differently on camera, or you just continue to be your same self?
Nah, I can't. I don't know how to be somebody else, man. I'm just me, man. I just gotta be real. You know, I'm a family guy. I love my family. I love my support system, my friends. I love the people that not just support me, but the people that support positive and good energy. So the producers, everybody that was a part of that team, they're like great individuals. You know what I mean? So if it was anybody that came contrary to what I believe in and to what I put forward out there into the world, to the atmosphere, the way I want the people to see me, then I wouldn't have done it. But those guys are so great, so genuine, and they made a promise and they kept that promise. And the process of the film was fun, making it was fun. And I could just be me. That's why I love about it. People said, "Oh, you're a great actor." I said, "I guess I'm a natural." But I was just being myself. And I loved every moment of it.
Now, this followed you and James threw up from 2015, right?
Yeah, 2015.
Okay. What amazed me, what threw me off for a second, was like, as I'm watching it, I'm saying to myself, like, looking at you, I see James, and then I see other fighters who are currently right now professionals, like Richardson Hitchens, Christopher Colbert, Julian Sosa, Jude Franklin, for a second, you know? And I was saying to myself, like, wow, you guys are all basically around each other, came through the ranks with each other, and things like that.
We're all climbing these pro ranks, you know? It's kind of like individual units in a sense, if that even makes sense.
Yeah, true that. Now tell everybody out there exactly, like, you know, what it is about being a New York City boxer and a New York City Golden Glove winner.
Oh man, there's no other Golden Gloves like it. For one, you get that gold chain, you get bragging rights forever. And it's the most respected amateur tournament, period. You know what I mean? So to be a champion, it's just you're wearing your city around your neck, you know what I'm saying? You're holding it close to your heart, and that's what we do. As fighters, we hold the New York City Golden Gloves close to our heart. Like, it's blood, sweat, and tears. We live for them six, whatever months, or and them years that we go into them Golden Gloves. We pull up the papers, and we open the newspapers after we won or fought, and we open it and we see it. Like, you live, breathe, and eat, and bleed boxing, you know what I'm saying? And it's almost hard to explain the feeling of it, but you're putting it all on the line. As a boxer, you're putting your life on the line. And it's the ultimate, in a sense, sacrifice. You have to give up so much stuff to be a champion. You have to give up so much stuff. You have to put so much courage and bravery into walking to that ring. and then competing with another man voluntarily that probably trained harder than you. You hoping he didn't, but he probably did or he probably didn't. You don't know until you know. You know what I'm saying? Until you find out. But it's just amazing. Being a boxer from New York, it's amazing. It's a good feeling. It's a lot of honor, a lot of pride, man.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you mentioned earlier, when you first were presented with this, you didn't really want to take part in it. Why is that?
I was ready to turn pro.
Oh, okay, you was ready to turn pro.
I've been around, Floyd and them, and it was, saying they was going to sign me, so I was just like ready just to turn pro.
Mayweather Promotions or just in general? You said who was going to sign you?
Floyd Mayweather.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Mayweather Promotions. I was going to sign with Mayweather Promotions, but it didn't end up happening. Mm-hmm. So around that time, I was just kind of over the amateur. I did it for so long. I was ready to enter the next phase of my career, my boxing career, the next chapter. Mm-hmm. And so when he presented that to me, that's the only thing that made me stay amateur. And when I did that, I said, okay, if I'm going to kill myself, I'm going to kill myself 1,000%. And I did it with the training. And then James made it that much easier to do it because I know he wanted that crown. And I didn't want him to have it. And I lost the year before, so I wanted my crown back. I needed to let them know I'm still the best fighter in 132. And then I felt in New York at the time. So it was amazing, man. It's amazing. Golden Gloves, I love it, man. First fighter to ever win in the Barclays Center at 132 pounds.
And you won the Sugar Ray Robinson Award.
I won the Sugar Ray Robinson Award in 2013.
Okay.
Yes, you're right. That year, you're right.
Yeah.
See, you know?
Yeah. Now, when you took the loss,
yeah.
How did that make you feel? Like, did that really give you, push you, motivate you to get back in the ring? And
you know what it is? Like, if you ask any of these guys that run these tournaments and the guys that came with me in the amateurs, they know I'm the comeback kid.
Yeah.
That's me. I could change my name to Titus the Comeback Kid Williams if I wanted to.
Yeah.
Feel me? Because that's what I do. I come back, I take a loss, I bounce back. That's what life is about. Mm-hmm. In life, sometimes you take losses, but it's about how you bounce back. Do you have the heart? Do you have the courage? Do you have the mindset to push through and win? Not just in the boxing ring, but in life.
Yeah.
So, with that being said, look out for my next professional fight.
And that's the clothing line God gifted.
The comeback kid is coming back.
Like you said.
And, God gifted, man.
Yeah.
God gifted is not just about winning, man. It's not just about being undefeated. God gifted is about having a gift, holding that gift, molding that gift, building that gift, and sharing that gift with the world, uplifting other people so they can go out there. Give them the courage to share their gift as well. God gifted, baby. Check me out too, God Gifted Will, on Instagram, Titus Williams on Facebook. Buy a hat, buy a shirt. I got some fly gear. Check it out. You'll like it.
Do you think that the film itself, because I believe it will, do you think it will uplift and inspire other kids and things like that?
Oh, yeah. That's another part of the reason why I did it. You know what I'm saying? Because I've been known to have that effect on people as far as inspiring them and motivating them. So you know what? If the media, the mass media, people's going to see this, then I want to be a part of it. So I want to inspire somebody. I want to motivate somebody. This will inspire and motivate somebody to let them know they can do this too.
Now,
and greater things.
This is coming out tomorrow on Showtime.
Tomorrow, Showtime, 8 p.m.
Okay. Is there any plans to take it cross seas to maybe cons or other festivals and things like that?
I'll talk to the producer. We'll see. See how big. There's no limits, man. When you got gifted, ain't no limits, man. We dealing with Showtime, ain't no limits.
All right.
We dealing with champions, ain't no limits.
Now, tell them the location for tomorrow's show.
Oh, I'm having my own personal screening tomorrow. Meet at 7:30, Bar Shimmy in Brooklyn. We have an after party too. We're just celebrating life, celebrating progression, progress, success, family, friends. Everybody come out. If you don't know me, you want to get to know me, I'll be there tomorrow. Come through. Have fun.
All right, man. Appreciate you.
All right, man. Appreciate you. Brooklyn Fights, check them out. Giving you the exclusives.
Thanks.